Hello, I'm Christine Niles. Today's July 12, 2021. Here are your latest Church Militant headlines. An SSPX priest is under fire for sending inappropriate text messages to teens. Parents are complaining about Father Jonathan Kopech, assigned to St. Mary's Academy in Kansas, for sending late-night texts to their underage daughters. In this one among many, Kopech refers to himself as Creeper, asking, just wondering if it's time yet, then, oh, I don't know, chat, have a dart, meaning have a cigarette, whatever. You said that maybe someday you tell me how it was all going. The SSPX has not responded to queries. In Europe, a Polish archbishop is asking for help after mishandling sex abuse claims. The Archdiocese of Krakow announced Friday a Vatican probe found Archbishop Viktor Skvorek acted negligently in two abuse cases from his former diocese of Tarnów. Skvorek requested the probe himself, has asked for forgiveness, offered to pay personally for abuse expenses, and is asking for a coadjutor bishop to assist him in his office. Heading east to Lebanon, the patriarch of the Maronite Catholic Church is warning against an influx of Muslim refugees. Cardinal Bechara Rai spoke at a webinar Thursday concerning the future of Christianity in Lebanon, addressing the country's delicate balance of religions. Rai cautioned against a large increase in Muslim refugees, explaining it would cause an imbalance in the state, a great deal of friction, which could possibly lead to war. Staying in Asia, the Filipino bishops have elected a staunch government critic for their leader. The conference confirmed Bishop Pablo David as its president Thursday, a firm defender of human rights who opposes government corruption and brutality. Bishop David has received death threats and criminal accusations for repeatedly criticizing Filipino President Rodrigo Duterte and his bloody and unpopular war on drugs. In the U.S., abortion activists in Arkansas defaced a statue of Christ in protest of pro-life laws. The group In Decline took credit for hanging a banner Friday reading, "God Bless Abortions," on a 67-foot statue known as Christ of the Ozarks. The activists were disguised as construction workers in order to desecrate the statue, protesting what they called dramatic attempts in Arkansas to ban abortion for needy women. And up north, a Canadian activist is getting scorched after urging that more churches be set ablaze. Harsha Walia, head of the British Columbia Civil Liberties Association, recently tweeted, "Burn it all down," in response to news two more Catholic churches had been torched. The backlash was immediate, with numerous tweets blasting Walia for promoting violence and demanding she be fired from her position. Walia has since made her Twitter page private. I'm Christine Niles. Those are your Church Militant headlines. Please watch The Vortex today. Michael talks about an international homosexual crime syndicate. God bless you.